We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at The Warlord, Issue 30. This is from Volume 1 from DC Comics, and is, of course, written and illustrated by Mike Grell. Inker was Vince Coletta, Adrian Roy, colorist, Ben Oda, letterer, Jack C. Harris, editor. Now, Morgan is heading back to Shambhala when he sees the Theron army, the entire garrison of the Theron army, marching toward Shambhala. Now, his plan is to go and alert the Shambhala people, but he has tons of obstacles in his way. There's this big kitty cat. There's a sea monster. Morgan finds this woodsman and tries to get him to help alert the settlements, which will in turn alert the main garrison that, hey, we got a problem. And the woodsman's hesitant because his wife and kid live nearby. And Morgan's like, look, they're not going to be the focus of the army. The army is going for the settlements first. So they end up having to split up to warn the settlements. But when they regroup, the army is already upon them. Now, what Morgan doesn't realize is we've seen this woodsman before, and he is the adoptive dad of a certain baby Joshua. Then Morgan doesn't know that. It's a very action-packed issue. A lot happens in a very short time as Morgan runs around trying to warn Shambhala about this coming military, and it was a lot of fun, actually. It was a surprisingly good time. Now, I love the cover. Even though that scene more or less doesn't happen, something similar does, but a lot happens. The sea monster and the jaguar scene are really cool. They're really dynamic and action-packed, so it's a good action issue. It doesn't really fill you in a whole lot about the Warlord, but it is a fun action-adventure issue. So if you're just looking for a quick read and some action, this is definitely your book. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I really like this series, and I cannot recommend it highly enough. This was just a good all-around story, and it continues to be a very solid series. Now, usually you can find these for a couple bucks. At most, I think the most I've paid for any single issue was like $2.50, so I don't think you'll have a problem finding it for an inexpensive price, and it's better written than most of the books on the newsstand today. So if you get a chance to check it out, please do so. Consider checking it out in the back issue section of your local comic shop. I really enjoy this series quite a bit, and I highly recommend it. But that's just my take. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing so you don't miss future reviews, and we hope to see you on the next one.